the feature!
Why would they praise a god that doesn't even exist? I wonder if that god answers your prayer. What do you think?
Keep quiet, lady. Why would you bother with that nonsense? There is really no god and no one can save us. Let's go now.
A day will come, and this world shall be turned into chaos. And even your God cannot save you. And this great city will be in crumble, and everyone will die.
Such an imprudent act!
A few months later, through the Holy Virgin Mary, God grant them a beautiful and lovely child named Apollonia. The couple's blissful smiles pictures a perfect life. They became a great parent, teaching her between the bad and good. Her mother now devotes Virgin Mary silently, and her father is still an atheist and only believes in the emperor as the supreme being. The child grew into a lovely maiden and graceful as a flower. Apollonia drank in all the details, and as she got older, there sprang up in her heart a strong desire to be baptized and become a Christian. and heaven did not leave her helpless. An angel came to her one day and led her out of Alexandria. "This is Apollonia, the servant of Jesus. Go now to Alexandria and preach the faith of Christ."
Madam, madam, you spare us some bread. My mother is sick. We've been starving for days now.
Quiet, young peasant. I barely have enough food for myself here.
Child, if you keep on doing this, you'll end up like us.
She's right, child. No one can save us here.
Little child, God will help you. Please share this with your mother. God exists and He shall help you.
Well, thank you very much, madam.
God bless you, little one.
What do you think you're doing, huh? I told you many times that you should never preach of that so-called God of yours.
But Father, God speaks to me in my dreams. The Lord Almighty wants me to send His divine message to the people of His great empire. Please, Father, please.
Silence! You know that the emperor already issued an edict that would persecute all Christians. Look what you have done!
No,
this may be hard for me to do, but this is our law.
No!
We must obey.
No! Father! No! Please! No! Father!
Apollonia!
Father, no!
Apollonia!
Father, no! Please! Please! Father, don't leave me here! Father! No! Father!
The rioters by this time were in the height of their fury. Alexandria seemed like a city taken by storm. The Christians made no oppositions, but betook themselves to flight and beheld the loss of their goods with joy, for their hearts had no ties on earth, just like the anonymous poet had foretold.
Can your God even hear your prayers? Can he save you now? I do believe in your God, cause I am God!
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth!
No one can save you now! Kill this woman and kill the rest!
No!
This is the preacher!
So this is the preacher!
God doesn't exist. Well, where is he now?
I refuse to do so, young man. God is watching me, and he is my salvation.
Say it, or we'll throw you into the fire.
Credo in Dio, Padre lo più potente. Creator in Kelly and the Red. Cristo.
Ose Dios densas. Naida never.
Credo in Dio. Patre omnipotente. Creator in Kelly and the Red. Et in His own Cristo. Filium Iis Unicum. Dominum nostrum, qui conceptus et de Spiritu Sancto, natus ex Maria Virgine, passus sub Pontio Pilato, crucifixus, mortus et sepultus, descendit ad inferna, tertia dei resurrexit a mortis, ascendit ad coelus, sedet ad exterram, de patris omnipotentis, in deventurus, Judice vivus et de mortus. Credum in the Spiritum Sanctum, Sanctum Ecclesiam Catholicam, Sanctorum Communionem, Resignationem Peccatorum, Carnes Resurrectionem, Vitam Aeternam. Amen.
Oh,
Ignoselis Kia! Neskit! Kid! Fuck you!
Christians were prohibited from worshipping the Roman gods or burning incense before an image of the emperor. Refusal resulted in the deaths of some notable Christians. The effects of the edict on Christian communities, many of which had until then lived peacefully and undisturbed, was traumatic. Christians had fled rather than face death, or who had performed the sacrifices, faced hostility from other Christians. By 251, efforts to enforce the edict had died down, and although short-lived, tradition persecution became in the collective memory of the church an episode of monstrous tyranny. Although Apollonia quitted life in this wise, nevertheless she received high honor as martyr in the Catholic Church, and their feasts are observed with great ceremony.